So it's currently May, and I'd like to make another video of my update of being back on Fiverr. As you remember me, I've been selling on Fiverr really heavily, making seven figures total since 2015. Yes, that's where I started to sell the Instagram marketing services. And now I'm back on Fiverr, so I took a break in 2020. I have not been selling any services or doing any sort of activities. And in 2021, I decided to be back on Fiverr. So as you remember, guys, if you haven't seen the previous video, I'll leave in the description the link where you can see how I got started, what kind of results I was able to get. And now this is a new update. So let's take a look. So first of all, as you can see here, this is my analytics. You can see the total earnings, total number of orders completed, total average selling price, and earned in May. Since this is just has been started May, so pretty much it's just beginning. So as you can see, when I did an update video, February was a 6,000, March a little bit more, and then April we almost hit 7,000, right? So, and as I was saying, you know, I'm currently a level two seller, so I'm a pro seller and a level two seller. So obviously there is interesting limitations when you're having different sort of levels. So let me actually quickly talk to you about this. So when you are pretty much like level zero, when you're just getting started, there is very interesting limitation on how many orders you can have in queue. So for example, let's say if you have 10, 15 orders in queue. So for example, if you take a look at my Instagram gig right here, right now I have 62 orders in queue, right? So when you're level zero, pretty much your gigs are not really visible anywhere, right? So you have to get to that level one status. It's certain algorithm changes, certain restrictions Fiverr has, but basically when you're level zero, your goal is to get as soon as possible to level one, right? And you have to meet certain requirements. So basically when you take a look at the requirements here, so you have to, you can click, for example, learn more, and you can see those requirements, right? So you have to be active for 60 days, complete 10 orders, earn $400 or more, maintaining good stats, and you're gonna get to level one, right? So I was level one pretty much in February, and you know, it definitely made some impact, but also I'm a pro seller. So when you take a look at the marketplace of pro services, of course, if you're a pro seller, you do get kind of a boost in your rankings and the search as well, right? So for example, right now my TikTok gig is in the pro section, and obviously it's getting pretty good traffic, right? So anyways, when I hit level two, there was an interesting fact where I started my Instagram marketing gig started to finally get in the rankings, in the search, right? And the reason behind it is because when you're level one, you pretty much have like 25 orders in queue maximum, and then your gig is gonna go off search. So you can still accept new orders, but basically you're not gonna, your gig is not gonna be visible in the rankings, in the search rankings, right? So when I got level two, that number is actually got pushed to 50 orders in queue. So, and at that time I had like 45 or something. So my gig became ranked. I started to use promoted gigs as well, which you can see here. I did spend $9 and I got $900 revenue, which was pretty insane, right? So things started to go. And then as soon as I hit 50 orders in queue, as you can see right here, let me just go back here. As soon as I hit 50 orders in queue, my gig went off rankings again, right? And then when I talked to the Fiverr support and my success manager, so basically that's the rule they have. So when you're level two, you can have up to 50 orders in queue, and then your gig goes off search, right? And it's kind of a weird, you know, limitation they have, but I understand. I mean, they're trying to, first of all, they're trying to keep the quality high, because not every seller are gonna have like 50 orders in queue, right? But in my case, because I'm doing Instagram marketing service where 30 days delivery means the actual how many days I'm gonna be working on the account, so that I just can't put less than that, right? So, but when you hit a top rate seller status, right, the pretty much the top one, the ranking system is different. So when you're a top rated seller, you don't have any limitations. That's where people can have 200 orders in queue, 300 orders in queue, and they will still be in the search, right? So that's what my goal is, to become top rated again, because I've been a top rated seller since 2016, 17, and then basically until 2020, I was a top rated seller. And then when I stopped doing any activities, I lost all of my levels, right? So, and just quickly to tell you, top rated seller, you have to, it's mainly vetted by Fiverr team. And most cases, they look at the buyer experience. Like, they want to see you have really good reviews. They want to see what people are saying about the reviews. Obviously, you have to be able to make all the stats. You have to have a really good completion rate, response rate, on-time delivery, right? So you got to have pretty much everything 100%, right? So, and that's where they give. But honestly, what I can suggest to you, if you're trying to aim for top rate seller, is to, if you do have this program, which is... it's called Seller Plus program, right? Where you basically, before it used to be like this, if you're doing pretty well, you're gonna have a success manager come to you, right? And they'll be like, hey, I'm gonna help you get better. I'm gonna help you achieve top rate seller, top rate status goal, right? And the success manager is gonna kind of like lead you and give you some tips, right? And then afterwards, they decided to remove the program and make it that called Seller Plus, where you have to pay for the program and then you're eligible to get a success manager. Plus you're gonna get all these upcoming events, webinars, new features, which in this case they have coupons, right? So you can actually create a coupon and send to your clients, which is pretty cool. I have not used this much yet, but probably gonna be using it. So yeah, they have a couple of, you know, good things for that. And yeah, so that's how you can get to the top rate status with having a success manager, right? Right now, it's obviously harder and, you know, they look at different ways. So just try to do your best, try to deliver, because there is a lot of sellers who are super successful, doing really well, but they can't reach top rate seller. And that's obviously multiple reasons. So I want to say just, you know, try to provide amazing experience for buyers, even give more so they can see that feedbacks. Because let me just give you some examples here. So if we take a look at the marketplace of Fiverr, so let's go, for example, at the regular marketplace, right? So we have a best selling, right? I went to the social media marketing category, and what you can see. So I can say this, this person, actually, I know this person personally, and he's been doing a really good job. As well with his gig, and it's just, you know, he has one gig, so he doesn't have many gigs, it's just one gig and he's doing it really well. So if you take a look at his reviews, and he became a top rate seller pretty recently, like a few weeks ago, if you just take a look at his reviews, you know, I mean, they're really good. So the people are writing long reviews, they're saying how great he is, right? I'm sure he's having like high percentages in terms of like completion rate, response rate, and other things, like it's 1 hour response time. I mean, it's pretty insane, to be honest, right? So yeah, he's doing really well, and that's why he earned it, right? It took him a few years to get to the top rated seller, but he made it, so it's pretty good. So if you take a look at other sellers, I mean, there's another people, by the way, this is, I would say, a top competitor at the moment for following and unfollowing, right? So these people are doing following and following. As you know, following and following still exists. You can still make this kind of service. And if you have not watched my previous video where I talk about which kind of services you can do, also take a look in the description and you can see what kind of services you can offer. So they are doing following and following, right? They have almost 300 orders in queue. And as you can see, they're actually in search as well. So pretty much they don't have any limitation right here. And they're having also pretty good reviews, right? So as you can see, reviews are amazing. So they're doing a good work, and people, that's what Fiverr is looking. Fiverr is looking for buyer experience, and that's where they're gonna give you top rate seller status, right? So that's what is happening. And I do encourage you, like, that's the way of Fiverr. The best way is that you can go at this sort of gigs and take a look what other people are doing, right? So that's what I highly recommend you, because, for example, this is another seller who is doing a manual growth. Looks like a manual, it might be not manual, like, who knows, right? But it's still, I mean, she's getting pretty good reviews as well. She has a lot of orders in queue, almost 200, which is actually pretty good. And you can see what is happening in her reviews as well, right? So she's getting pretty good reviews, you know, sometimes just normal 5 stars, some people write long reviews, so it's pretty good, but she's still level 2 seller, right? So something is missing. Yeah, so it's not fast process, unfortunately, but you gotta put a lot of work, you gotta focus on buyer experience as well. So another thing is what I can suggest, you know, if you take a look at the pro marketplace, and obviously there is less competition there because there is less gigs, but it has a lot of traffic. And at the same time, I mean, it's harder to say because I see pro is more expensive. So of course, maybe for Fiverr, some people are not ready to spend that much money on Fiverr, but still, you know, my gig is there on TikTok. And I mean, I wouldn't say it's doing amazing. Like, I'm getting a lot of review orders, but still, like, I'm at 10 currently, which is pretty good in my case. And it's growing, right? So I have like 3 reviews so far, which is pretty good. So yeah, I definitely see potential there. It always, you know, when you're on Fiverr, it always takes time to grow. Like, you know, I think in everything you do, it takes time to grow, but on Fiverr, you have to be really patient. You can't be just starting from zero and make, like, let's say $10,000 per month in the second or third month, right? It's usually a very slow and grow, you know, slow process. Even if you take a look, if I show you some of my, let's say 2017, that's where I could actually show you the stats, right? So I was at the college at that time, and you can see the graph here. So it's slowly growing, and then suddenly, you know, I'm reaching 26, 30K and more, right? And then 2018, 2019, it's always been pretty consistent and always been pretty high, right? So, and here, that's where a lot of changes started to happen, right? So you can see there's a major declines. And then 2020, like I said, I took a year off, so I was not doing anything. And 2021, it started to look promising. Like, I think it's pretty consistent so far. But you know, you have to think about also pushing people to your gigs, right? Not only on Fiverr, but outside of Fiverr. So you have to find ways where you can just push people outside from your social media, from your blogs, from your YouTube, and just, you know, bring that traffic to your Fiverr gigs. And that's going to also play a big impact in the algorithm, in the reviews, in the system as well. So that's what I would recommend to focus on. But my update is almost 7k in April. May, we're gonna see, because obviously I'm level 2, so my gigs are not in search fully on Instagram, so I can't really push it. But I'm gonna try to push more people outside and bring it to Fiverr and just see how it's gonna go. Another thing which I can suggest you as well, which I have done in the past, it's opening multiple gigs. So maybe you're doing the same service, but it's obviously a little bit different. So for example, in this case, so if you take a look at my previous gigs, which are paused at the moment, but I had 2 gigs, which was the same service pretty much, but it was different duration. So 1 gig was 2 weeks promotion, another gig was 1 month promotion. So it's not exactly the same, but there is still some sort of differences there. So you can do that, and that way you're able to basically get more traffic, because my 2 gigs, which is Grow Your Instagram and another Grow Your Instagram, right? They were at the top of the search, and I was getting traffic to both gigs, right? So it's basically scaling, right? You can do that, but just be careful. Don't do these exactly the same gigs, you know, let's say 2 gigs, exactly the same service, exactly the same description, right? So they have to be different. So right now, I actually have a new gig, which is removing ghost followers. And that's one of the services I also mentioned in the previous video. So we're gonna see how it's gonna go. I'm not sure right now. Obviously there is a demand, but that's the best thing about Fiverr, because you can launch those kind of services, and then you can see how they're doing. For example, TikTok, I launched it a few weeks, maybe actually a month ago now. And it's been going pretty well. You know, I'm getting more orders. I don't see a lot of reviews yet, but you know, still people are ordering, people are happy so far with it. So yeah, you know, just wanted to say, play around, look at the marketplace, look what other people are doing, and try to, you know, use it and then understand how they're doing the service. And then you can just model, don't copy, but you can model their service, right? So guys, let me know if everything is clear. If you're selling on Fiverr, if you want to sell on Fiverr, just let me know if you need any help or if you're struggling. I'm going to be also launching a series of Fiverr kind of like trainings, because I've been selling a course before on Fiverr. It's been a very high production course, and right now I decided to put it as a playlist on YouTube and just basically share it with you for free. So I really appreciate your support. Give a thumbs up to this video if you like it, and of course I'll appreciate if you subscribe to the channel. So let me know if you have any questions, and thank you so much again for watching this video, and have a great day, and see you in the next one.